think. This is about making the rock star evolve into a professor the other way around. The rock star professor found by accident that he had a strange past that changed his present. The future was also linked with the past as well as the present. Past, present, and future. Evolution begins to curve at the edges, and who can blame it?
And so, until our hero and heroine are all they film and illness.
They met on their own for a boarding railway station. Not so much a station, more a hut at a strange village somewhere in a neglected corner of England.
Thank you. So I would like you to tidy the castle keep.
Me.
I don't know the first thing about that house. Listen! What is it? The front doorbell.
Listen! I didn't hear a thing.
answers. Who are you?
I am Igor.
You look like that horn dog.
In fine company. I'm back. Come with me.
They travelled in silence for 3 days, eventually arriving at the foreboding castle deep in the mountains.
Enter.
As Rocky stepped inside, a curious feeling came over him. That's the way they used to talk in the 60s, just ask Mrs. Spade.
Is good. Is yours.
Mine? What do you mean, mine?
I am true descendant of original order, and it's you who are directly in line. You are heir. The castle and all its contents belongs to you.
Who was this old geezer that did his father?
His name was Baron Frankenstein.
In a glass case kept in reserve with some of Bart's notes on his experiments, the more he learned and saw in the castle, the more he was convinced that his life to date with the witch and the glamour had been leading up to this moment.
Igor?
Yes, master.
I'm going away to learn the science of genetics. I should be gone 7 years. Wait for me in Bart's place while I'm here.
With my life, it's good. The blood of the Baron runs through in your veins, Herr Franks. Or should I say, Herr Frankenstein?
The professor was only 2 weeks at the bottom of their request, and 2 years since having done pure scientific research. Little did he know the shock that was still waiting.
Can we go
doubled in its intensity as it passed directly overhead. You may have noticed that Professor Franks never mentioned that the predecessor he spoke of was Baron Frankenstein. The Baron could have caught kept meticulous records of left barons, and most of them were destroyed by an arcade genome. So the Professor would not have known that creatures had been brought alive by a bolt of lightning, which is in the long dead spirits of the castle.
Oh, I'm in love. The legend was truly being relived, for
just as the peasants around the Frankenstein castle have gone and eaten, so the villagers of Henton were beginning to grumble with discontent.
Because
Professor Grant? Could power bring him?
Sad effect.
Aye, I mean it is.
Then you do something about it.
Certainly. I now have legal grounds to investigate the castle. Mother Mac, which is home then, my sniffer dog will soon root him out.
This sniffer dog?
Yes, madam.
Would that be the hand of the Baskerville?
I must apologise for that awful joke. However, I assure you there's worse to come. The next year, the laboratory, the frenzy of activity, is work on the professor's project name, completion.
Thank you.
this gripping tale is about a rigid, stunning climax. The day of the concert arrived and the villagers together with Inspector Baskerville made their way to the castle.
As the guests assembled, the startling entertainment, the first rumblings of thunder were heard.
How curious that all the major events of this strange story are always accompanied by a big storm.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honour for me to be here tonight to present to you this fabulous festival of fun and frolics. Are you going to raise a roof tonight?
Raise a roof? I left my old pal on the car.
Say, roof. I'll get a ladder.
And I'll get a screwdriver.
No. He didn't mean actually take the roof off. He meant make a lot of noise.
So let's see you all. I said all. Please welcome the black, the red nose frog!
Thank you.
Thank you. Household, do you
circle, just as the fire destroys the original Frankenstein and his monsters. It did Professor Franks and his monsters. That if they were monsters. Now we shall never know, as far as panic and pandemonium, several villagers lost their lives and only three occupants survived.
Thank you.